bring folks up to speed, early on, while police were advancing on the tree and the tree sitters, we also had Deputy Chief Israel coming on site initially to address the appearance of an encampment, much like the same conversation we had 2 weeks ago, where, in fact, DC Israel himself was given a photograph of the appearance of the camp, and we were assured hands were shook, things were said, like, things look great, keep it up. And so the appearance was not an issue. As long as that was not an issue, it was fine that we were here. But as of that Thursday and Friday, the Friday raid, a week prior, Lieutenant Hamilton and his crew came out, and they were the ones who were manipulating a law to forcibly remove everyone and their belongings out of the space. So today, DC Israel came back out again, initiating a similar conversation that the appearance was the issue. While we were working to hear and address that, because of course our bins and things that we have used to keep things clean and organized have been removed as part of that raid. Yet again, another instance of that. As we were having that conversation, more focusing on keeping things clean and orderly as we wish to do so, Lieutenant Hamilton arrived on site, and the conversation then shifted. His statement was that he is now being put in charge of this and that he is returning at 2 p.m. to clear out everything. So our standpoint is to make clear the First Amendment is our permit. We have every right to be here. That there should not be a question of whether or not we are allowed to be here. That if they're going to enforce the laws in this manner, that they must acknowledge, one, that they are backing down and reneging on their word and agreement there, but also that they are selectively enforcing this law. That, for example, I, as someone who have a backpack on me that has some food and blanket, at no other point have I ever, when I've been in this space, been approached or told the same things or been forcibly removed. Nor have I ever been given a citation when, for example, I, myself, or someone else has come through this plaza, maybe on lunch or as a member of the public. So it is very clear that not only are they flipping on their word, that even DC Israel himself acknowledged that that is an issue, but that in that very moment, yet again, just like they did 2 weeks ago, having one end of the department, mind you, Deputy Chief Israel and a lieutenant, contradicting each other and having us caught in the crossfire, but that even today, right before us, DC Israel arrived to say one thing. We conferred as a group. We came back to update him about what the group had decided. And as before we could even communicate that, Lieutenant Hamilton put himself in front of me and said, no, I am being put in charge of this now. Showed frustration that we were even trying to continue that conversation with DC Israel, and inserted that by 2 p.m. everything must go. So it's the same vicious cycle over again. They're not only are they holding to their own word within the police department, which again, the question of whether or not we can, should trust and respect the department, but that also, on top of that, again, the recurrence of selective enforcement of the law being used, being wielded to oppress the people and to forcibly remove not only our belongings, but trying to silence us out here as well.
Okay, I'll broadcast this. Thank you.
Thank you.